Hello everyone, so today we will have another topic to discuss, which is all about the set. So what is a set then? So a set class is a collection of distinct objects or elements, by which we mean that the order does not matter. And if an element is repeated several times, we only care about one instance of the element. Set class are often specified with curly brace notation. So that is the symbol for curly brace. The opening and closing curly braces denote a set. So we use a set class to represent, a brace to represent a set. Okay, now so let's have some examples of set. So from the definition of a set class, diba sabi dun that a set is a collection of distinct objects or elements, which means an distinct class, ibig sabihin that it should be specific, okay? Hindi yung masyadong broad nung tinutukoy ng set na hindi mo maiisip or malalaman kaagad kung ano ba yung mga elements na pwede nating ilagay doon sa set na tinutukoy. Okay? So, just like for the first example, the set of positive even integers. So, pagkabasa mo pa lang doon sa sentence na the set of positive even integers, mapapaisip ka na kung ano yung mga elements that are members or yes, the elements na nakapaloob dito sa set na to. So, let's say in naming a set pala class, we use capital letters. So, any letters from the English alphabet kung anong gusto nyo. But we use capital letters. So, let's say we name the number 1 as set A. So, set A is the set of positive integers daw. So, we use the open brace. So, even, tapos positive integers pa. So, we start with 0. Yes, 0 is an even number. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, and so on and so forth. Yan. So, kung mapapansin nyo, gumamit ako ng ellipsis dito class. So, itong sunod-sunod na tuldok na tatlo class are what we call the ellipsis. Wherein we use, sometimes we use this one because if we don't know the ending of the elements of the set. So, dito, sabi di kasi dun sa una, positive even integers, ibig sabihin, madami. Madaming positive even integers. At alangan naman isulat natin yan. So, all we have to do is to use the ellipsis wherein, ang sinasabi nito that these even numbers here are continuous. Okay? Walang hindi natin alam kung saan ang dulo niya. Okay? So, this is how we write from the first example, the set of positive even integers. Ganito po tayo magsulat ng set wherein this 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 are what we call the elements. Elements, yes, or objects of the set. Okay? So, next example, number 2, let's say we name the number 2 as set B. So, set B. So, number 2, the set of natural numbers. So, ano naman kaya yung mga natural numbers? So, we all know that natural numbers are what we call also the counting numbers wherein these natural numbers, we start with 1. Okay? So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and so on and so forth. Yan. So, hindi na naman natin alam kung saan ang hanggan itong natural numbers. That's why we use the ellipsis again. And the third one, the set of primary colors. So, ano ba yung mga set ng primary colors? Ano ba yung mga primary colors natin? Kapag yung number 3, the set of colors, so masyadong broad yung tinutukoy niya. Anong colors? Yung mga primary colors ba? Mga secondary colors din ba? So, anong mga colors yung tinutukoy ito? So, yung sinasabi ko nina that A set should be specific, it should be distinct. So from the number 3, let's say we name it a set C. So the set C of primary colors. So what are the primary colors? So the primary colors are red. I'm not sure kung one red, yellow, and blue. Okay, so the three, so the primary colors are the red, yellow, and blue. Then close bracket. Ayan, di ba? So, mas specific yung tinutukoy niya, the primary colors, okay? So, these are the examples of set. Okay, so let's have some examples again. So, we have three examples here wherein set A is the set of vowels. Of course, the set of vowels are the A, E, I, O, U. So, the members or the elements of this set A are A, E, I, O, U. For set B, the set of first year IT students enrolled in JEC 102. Of course, ang ilalagay lang natin dito na elements itong set B na to are those students first year lang. Kasi there are some irregular. Ayan, there are some irregular here. So, pero yung sinabi niya lang doon ay mga first year IT. Ayan, specify niya IT lang. Students enrolled in JEC 102 or what we call the mathematics in the modern world. And set C, the set letters in the English alphabet. So, letter C, set C, I mean, are those letters from the English alphabet, which are the A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, and Z. Okay, so these are some examples again of a set. Okay, so let's have the membership of a set. Membership or element of the set. Okay, let's say class, we have set B here wherein X is one of the elements of B. Let's see. Yeah. Si X daw ay one of the elements or members of B. So kapag si X ay one of the members ni set B, then X is an element of B. Okay, so this symbol stands for an element. Ibig sabihin, membro. Si X ay miyembro siya kaysa set B. We read this as X is an element of B or X belongs to B. Pero, kapag naman, let's say, Y, meron naman tayong Y, si Y ay hindi siya member sa set B. Okay? Y is not belong to the set B, then Y is not an element of set B. Okay? Y is not an element of set B or Y does not belong to B. So, this is how the membership of a set or the elements of a set. Okay? Okay, just like for example, class, balikan natin yung previous examples natin ng set kanina. Let's say yung set A is that the set of vowels. So, the set of vowels. So, ano yung mga elements or members nitong the set, yung set A natin na tinutukoy niya ay the set of vowels. So, we have the set A R, the set of A, E, I, O, U. So which means class that, okay, medyo manabo siya. Which means that si A class is a member of the set A. Ito. Si A is a member of the set A. See, E is a member, is an element of the set A. How about letter B? Is letter B is an element of the set A? No. Hindi siya part ng vowels. Therefore, B is not an element of set A. Okay? So, don't forget this symbol, ha? Element or part of or member of. And dito naman, not part of or not member of or does not belong to the given set. Okay. Now, let's move on with the two ways on how to specify a set class. We have two ways. First, let's have the roster or tabular method. So, what does roster or tabular method means? Which means class, we only need to list or enumerate the elements of the set. So, we just do by, all we have to do is to list or do by listing. So, ililista lang natin or i-enumerate lang natin yung mga elements of this set. Okay, just like for example, here, we have the first set, which is the set A, wherein the set A is the set of the first 10 natural numbers. So, first 10 natural numbers in specify niya class. So, we have set A is equal to, so open brace, what are the first 10 natural numbers? So, those are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Ayan. So, nilista lang natin yung mga elements that is part of the set A. Okay, how about the second example? The set of first 5 prime numbers. So, set B is equal to the set of first 5 prime numbers. So, what is the first prime number? So, that is 2. Then, ano sunod? 3. Then, 5. 7. Then, 11. So, ayan na yung first 5 prime numbers natin. So, that's how roster method works. All we have to do is to list. We can also do the complete listing. Kagaya nitong ginawa ko class na kinompleto kong nilista lahat ng mga members or elements of the set. Or pwede rin partial listing. Paano kapag partial listing? Kagaya nung ginawa ko kanina. Yung tawag dito. Gumamit ako ng ellipsis. Kagaya dito. Kapag tinamad na kayo magsulat ng 1 to 10, pwede nating tanggalin ito. So, since alam naman natin na yung mga numbers dito, part before dito is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, sunod-sunod. Therefore, pwede rin dagdagan ng 6, then, comma, tapos 10. Ibig sabihin that the elements of the set A are 1 up to 10. Okay? Kasi wala namang in-skip na number dito kung mapapansin nyo sa unahan. So, that is partial listing. We can use the ellipsis. Pero careful lang kayo sa paggamit ng partial listing kasi minsan kahit na na-cover siya doon sa set na yon, pero hindi natin makita yung ano, hindi natin makita yung parang difference. Kaya yan, kasi may mga part doon na may possible na pwede kayong gumamit ng partial listing. Tapos, dito pala sa sunod-sunod na numbers na to, ay may mga hindi siya part doon sa tinutukoy ng set. So, doon minsan nagkakamali yung mga ibang estudyante. So, careful lang tayo kapag gumamit tayo ng partial listing. Okay, so let's have the second one. So, the second one is the set builder notation. So, what is a set builder notation? So, kapag set builder notation naman class, kung ang roster method ay we do the listing, kapag set builder notation, we describe. So, we give description to the elements of the given set. So, dine-describe natin kung ano yung mga elements dun sa given set. Wherein we have a pattern. So, the pattern is, or yes, pattern or basis kung paano ginagamit or how we write a set builder notation. So, let's say we have the set A, any capital letter that represents a set. So, set A is equal to the set of X. So, this X class represents or it is used as a symbol for any element of the set. So, this one is stands for any element. Kung ano yung nilalaman ng set. Ito yung tinutukoy ng X. Such that, itong P of X naman class is the defining condition. Ibig sabihin, kung ano yung description, kung ano yung pwede mong i-describe doon sa elements of the set. So, P of X is the, it is the defining, the definition, so defining condition of the elements of the set. Okay, just like for example, we have set, two examples here, set A and set B. So, set A, kapag, paano natin basahin yan, ma'am? Ganito natin basahin ito. Set A is the set of X such that X is a plane figure. Okay? So, dito, this symbol stands for such that. Again, set A is a set of X such that X is a plane figure. So, ibig sabihin class, yung nilalaman daw ni set A, yung mga elements daw sa set A ay mga plane figures. So, ibig sabihin sa set A, ang mga elements niya ay triangle, quadrilateral, parallelogram, parallelogram pala is a part of quadrilateral, quadrilateral, pentagon, hexagon, heptagon, octagon, nonagon, andecagon, dodecagon. So, those are plane figures. So, yun yung mga yon ang mga nilalaman ni set A. So, set A is a set of X such that X is a plane figure. Now, for the second example, the set B. Set B is the set of X such that X is first five counting numbers. So, yung mga nilalaman daw ni set B ay mga yung mga first five counting numbers. So, ano yung mga yon? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So, set B is the set of X such that X is first five counting numbers. So, that is how we use the set builder notation. We describe, we give description with the elements of the set. While tabular method, we list down or we enumerate the elements of the set. That ends our discussion for today. I hope you've learned something about the introduction or first part of the set. So, thank you for watching. God bless everyone. Bye-bye.